Democrat, Republican, Libertarian, it's easy to focus on the larger political movements out there, but what about the Transhumanist Party? Last I checked, Zoltan Istvan was still running in hopes of becoming your first transhumanist US president. It raises the question, just what is transhumanism after all? Transhumanists just held their Augmented World Expo in San Jose. In the broadest possible terms, transhumanism is all about the improvement of the human condition through science and technology. We're talking Homo sapiens 2.0 here, upgraded via technology to become smarter and stronger. Yet the particulars of the vision run the gamut of existing human politics and encompass everything from mere science-driven culture to the outright evolution of the human species. For starters, just consider some of the various schools of transhumanism to emerge since the 1980s. We've got democratic transhumanists who want advancements for every socioeconomic level, libertarian transhumanists and anarcho-transhumanists who think advancements will elevate us all just fine if the government stays out of it. We also have survivalist transhumanists who just want to defeat death. You've got singularitarians who see transhumanism as an inevitable outcome of the technological singularity. We can't avoid it, all we can do is prepare for it and manage the outcome. Meanwhile, transhuman hedonists just want to feel good, and religious transhumanists weave it all together with their faith. Those are just a few of the approaches. In any case, the next big question is, how will we know we've become transhuman? In 2011, bioethicist Kyle MunKittrick presented 7 potential indicators. First, we'd need to reach the point where prosthetic limbs and implanted organs are actually improvements over the original. We're not there yet. Second, we'll need to have better brains by virtue of neuroimplants and cybernetics. We're talking a step beyond pharmaceutical power-ups here, and we'd have to be clear that it's not cheating, not brain doping, but a desired upgrade in human cognition. We're not quite there yet either. Third, artificial intelligence and augmented reality would need to be a part of everyday life. Now, based on the phone app that basically drove me to work this morning, I think we're at least getting there. Fourth, we'll want an average human lifespan of roughly 120 years. Fifth, according to MunKittrick, we'll want human reproduction to transcend into more of a responsible planning choice. Some work to be done on both of those. Sixth, we'll each need total legal bodily freedom to engage in the sort of cybernetic upgrades necessary to achieve a higher human form. Right now, that's tied up in a lot of governmental red tape. And seventh, MunKittrick argues, we need a strong value of personhood for qualifying non-human entities, such as artificial intelligences and dolphins. After all, no one wants to upgrade themselves out of their basic human rights, right? These are just a few overarching ideas about transhumanist identity. But where do you stand? What does it mean to be transhuman, and how will we know when we get there? Let us know, and if you want more futurist visions, be sure to check out now.howstuffworks.com.